Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ne bataya sadhu sangha.
Hindi, and then I'll translate it.
Oh, the suspense.
So Marshall will speak in Hindi, and then Prabhu there will translate it into English.
Is that Sunilanda from Fiji?
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Sorry, I'm not sure. Is it okay?
Yes.
Yes, it's very good, very good.
Sadhu Sham and Namavitan. Most powerful. Sadhan. Sadhusam, sadhusam, sarvasastri koi. Lava matra sadhusam, sarvasiddhi hoi. So you are try your level best.
It was English, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The
best.
The arrow is sort of
going
on his face.
Oh, okay. That's the unknown thing about India. Things come and go quickly.
Who is sadhu?
Yes.
Who is sadhu?
After, then you have to search sadhu. First of all, you have to know who is sadhu. Sadhu means those persons are attached to its Godhead in their body, mind and soul. They are sadhu. If we attain the satsanga but not in mind, a soul that is not called satsanga. Satsanga, without satsanga, the attained gathering is no satsanga. I heard from today one man, so-called devotee of Islam, he committed suicide. His wife told me now he is a ghost or anything. I am replied that sadhu never can suicide because they are not, it is impossible because he can lose his body but not in mind or soul. The satsanga means first of all we have to know who am I? I am not a body. I am not a subtle body. I am soul. Soul is eternal. Fire will not burning the soul. Water will not wet the soul. And wind is not dry the soul. Noja yote mriyote ba kada chin naram hutta bhavita na bhuya. Soul is not born. Soul is not dead. Noja yote mriyote. Nainam chindanti sastrani. Sastra will not cut the soul. Nainam dahati pavaka. The soul was not burn by the fire. Na jainam kredenta, na sasayati maruta, adajyoham, acheddeyam, apredya asasdevacha, nitya sattvagata, sthanur, achala ayam sanatana. That is the soul. That if anybody realizes these things, then he never commits suicide. Like suicide, a blunder mistake. It is impossible. They can destroy their body, gross body. This is not the real satsanga. If satsanga is possible, if you are all gathering the satsanga and know the real self, I mean the soul, three kind of food in our daily necessity, bodily food, mentally food, and soully food. Soul food is the Harinam Sankirtan. Those who perform Harinam Sankirtan with the self-realization, then he is a sadhu. Like the flower maker, garland maker, they are the cause of satsanga of the Brahmins, of Brajamandal, the wives of garland maker. They are collect flowers from the jungle, and the Brahmanis, the wife of the Jagyik Brahman, they are listen the Harikatha from the gardener's wife. The gardener's wife was considered a sadhu, but not the Jagyik Brahman. Although they are all conversant with the Shastra and they are expert to perform yoga, yet without satsanga, they cannot realize himself and he cannot do properly the result of satsanga. So, sadhu is considered that person who is realized himself, this kind of person. This is the main thing before satsanga. Anybody that perform tilak, that perform sankirtan, they are not called devotee, real devotee. Real devotee who is realized himself, I am the servant of, eternal servant of Lord Krishna, not other things. I am also eternal. Nitaye charan satya tahar sevaka nitya. In Veda mantra, tadvishno paramam padam sada pasyanti suraya. Diviva Chakshudratatam Vishnu Rijat Paramam. Vishnu is eternal, and the sevak of Vishnu also eternal, and the seva puja, sankirtan, also eternal. This is the first thing to realize himself. Then sankirtan. Otherwise not possible but sankirtan.
Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj Ki
Jai.
Maharaj, they're like looking after everybody. He has to give a garland.
Maharaj, Srila Maharaj is offering his garland.
Yes, I've got it on me.
Please tell Maharaj that we are so happy to see him and hear his Harikatha, and that we are very indebted to him.
Let's go there so we can see before.
Yeah, he can see me. Can he see me?
I don't
yes,
think
he can see
well.
Me. I can see over there.
That's okay. I am happy to see you all.
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Thank you.
Then Maharaj.
We have a couple of people watching, right?
I was thinking that maybe we sit in a circle and each person share a little bit about what they experienced there with Maharaj. Because in that way, everybody picked up something. And I will give some explanation a little bit later, you know, just to clarify what Maharaj has said. In brief, Maharaj was saying that all that glitters is not gold. Means that we, something may look like gold, but it's not really gold. So much imitation is there. So that we may look like a devotee, we may dress like a priest, we may dress like a bishop, we may dress like a Hare Krishna. We can dress in so many ways. But unless one actually understands that they are a soul, a servant of the Supreme, eternally, that unless that relationship has begun, then one can, like he said, someone can commit suicide. Someone can do something that is unheard of. Why? Is because there's no sambandha, relationship. Because nothing has entered in. He gave the example of the yogic Brahmins. The yogic Brahmins, they were great, great Brahmins, chanting so many prayers to Krishna, and worshipping Krishna, and doing so much. There's this big fire that's going on, and they're throwing this in, all these yogic Brahmins in India we're talking about. And everybody's saying swaha, swaha, like these, all these chants and meditations. You might have heard them on the TV or different in India maybe. But when Krishna needed something, he told his cowherd boys, go and ask the yogic Brahmins. So they went to, the cowherd boys went there, and they were so busy in their yajna to God that they said, basically, we've got no time right now. Can I come back later? We'll talk to you later. We're doing this. But their wives, who seemingly weren't important, they immediately went to help Krishna. And they ran towards Krishna because they had had the association of the gardener. The gardener was a devotee. And so had explained and loved Krishna and explained this to the wives of the Brahmins.
So they were devotees, means that their love for Krishna, because they associated with a devotee, means someone devoted to God, that their hearts were touched in a real way. That's what Maharaj is saying, their hearts were touched in a real way. And so therefore he talks about sadhu sangha. What is real sadhu sangha? One who has connected to, from their heart to God. So because they had connected through the association of the gardener, therefore they heard Krishna calling, Krishna needs some help, I'm going, immediately. And then what happened? The yogic Brahmin said, if you go, they'll throw you out, you can never come back. Don't ever come back again. The yogic Brahmin said that. But they went because they felt Krishna calling them in their heart. And what happened is they went to Krishna and they came back and their husbands thought, my God, what fools we are. Because what did Krishna do? He made those yogic Brahmins forget, in one sense, that they had said, throw them away. Don't ever come back. So even though they were in a dire situation, they took that risk, and Krishna arranged it, and they came back, and then those Brahmins realized, oh God, we've made a big mistake. So Maharaj is explaining that the importance of sadhu sangha, because by connecting to the sadhu, then we get something real in our heart. And secondly, a really nice point Maharaj made, such a beautiful point, is that we might be here physically, but are we here with our mind and heart? Isn't it? We can do so many things. You know, we're very expert at multitasking in the modern world, you know, but unless we're here with our mind and our heart. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. There was one disciple. Bhaktisiddhanta is the Swami. Are you right? You kind of... Yeah? That he was in the temple and so many devotees came to the temple. And he said to one of his assistants, who is this person? And he said, Maharaj, he's been in the temple for 2-3 years. So I've never seen him before. No, he's been here for 2-3 years. You must know him. I've never seen him before. And what Srila Bharati Maharaj was explaining to us was that he might have been there physically, but he wasn't there in his heart.
But he was that day then.
Well, he must have been that day, yes. That day he got to
listen. So it must have, the association must have rubbed off on him.
Something happened. Meaning that even though we might be physically there, but he wasn't present. Also, another time, everybody was sitting quietly around Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and there was this one person, and he pointed over to him, and he said to the other devotees, why is he always speaking? And everybody looked at Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, because, you know, everybody was quiet. Why is he continually speaking? And he was getting annoyed. And obviously his mind was just going and going and going and going. So although he was there, his mind was going all the time. That Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada knew, oh, he's always talking, he's always busy. So this is what Maharaj is trying to emphasize, a really beautiful point, is that without us being present within our heart, like when we do seva, when we serve, if we're not doing that with our, if we're doing it with our heart, how much that connects with the other person, isn't it? It's like if you do something to please somebody, and you're not really interested in them, and you just think, oh God, I have to do this, then that person doesn't really pick up very much from you. But if we're doing devotional service means loving service, then because of that loving service, then we receive so much and they are pleased with us.
How can we serve and when we serve, how can we be conscious of whether we are present and being devoted? And if we are not, if we're conscious that we're not, how can we upgrade that to devotion?
I'll give you my own example.
For people's like lives, like yeah. People who work.
I was, you can put this in your everyday life because it's applicable for your everyday life. I was with Maharaj and serving him, and my mind was somewhere else. And I put something in the wrong place in Maharaj's room. And then I went out, and then I came in and did something else, and then I went out, and then I came in and then did something else and went out. And Maharaj was going like this. He says, "You're coming in, you're going out. You're coming in, you're going out." That was fine, but because my mind wasn't there, I wasn't able to serve Maharaj in a pleasing way. So what I understood is that if you really care about serving and somebody, then you will want to pay attention to the small things. So by being attentive, as in present in what we are doing in this moment in our life, in terms of, you know, putting the cup of water in the right place, putting the plate in the right place, by being present in our daily activities, that is devotion. Because we are being attentive to do something for that person very beautifully that is pleasing to that person. Because seva is about pleasing, isn't it? If we're doing seva, we're doing service to please the other person.
But you're with Maharaj all the time. How do we serve Maharaj when we're not?
Well, there's physical connection, and it's vapa.
That's right.
There's physical presence and following instructions.
Yes.
But might I say, It occurs to me that the one thing we all need to make advancement is sincerity. There's no point pretending. And that's just fooling yourself and fooling others to be a pretender, like you say, like Maharajas, who is the real sadhu amongst all the pretenders? Yes. It's all right to put the uniform on, to even talk the talk, but you have to walk the walk. And it occurs to me you have to be sincere in your own, personally sincere, and you cannot be fooled. But then also, if you don't have association of the Vaishnava, as someone who's, you know, who's doing it properly, you don't stand a chance. You have to have that association. It's like a candle touching another lit candle. And without that, there's nothing. So that's what I mean.
Yes. So let's finish with Yashodhana Prabhu. He's saying that basically, Hare Krishna. He's saying that if we are doing seva, how can we be what? Present? How can we remember?
Well, I'm just observing for people who are, everyone in this room is at different stages. And I'm observing you're with Maharaj 24/7. We're not with Maharaj 24/7. So how do we translate what you're saying to our lives on a daily basis?
The first thing is by chanting Harinam. If we chant Harinam, if we chant the names of God, then we're automatically being in the service of God and his devotees. So if we're chanting, Harinam brings us into remembrance. So Harinam is one thing. By reading the Shastra, by reading the scriptures, that's helping us remember. By worshipping the deity, there's also, we're reminded. So there are different activities of devotional seva that we can do. If we are in a work, we can understand, well, Maharaj says that if we put 5p or 5 paisa every day away for the guru, we will remember that guru every day. Because, oh, this is for Guru Day. So one little act that we do each day, specifically for our guru, our teachers, then we remember them daily. So then daily practice. And we can remember if we've been to India and met our teachers, them. It's like, oh, I remember I was in the room with Maharaj.
Many audio tapes and videos available these days. So
remind us.
I never met Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Never. I joined ISKCON the following year after he passed away. But nevertheless, I felt he was my guru at the time, you know, the one who'd called me to Krishna consciousness, and it was by virtue of his books and his videos and his recordings. Mm. And that's there with many of the acharyas that we're following. There's much of writing.
That's right.
But I'll say it again, though. We need association, because even on your own, and even a so-called advanced devotee, if they're alone, it can, advanced devotee, he's never away from Krishna. He's never alone. She's never alone. But maybe the middle level devotees, those of us who have been chanting many years and waking the deity for many years, how do you stop that becoming stale? How do you stop that becoming like, you start off full of enthusiasm, mindful, and then it becomes a chore, perhaps. Even perhaps chanting the japa each day can become like,
yes, there's so many
fresh.
Yes, by association of devotees, just like we are sitting here listening to Maharaj.
Yeah.
Everybody feels some enthusiasm, some connection.
He managed to say it all, I thought.
Anybody else have any points that they've talked to me?
Yeah, taking this one point Maharaj made, which pertains to me quite strongly, because I have a lack, I feel the lack of sadhusanga quite strongly in Brighton. Not many sadhus come through here, and we don't have that many programs going, so it really pertains to me, and I was thinking, not always is the physical aspect of sadhusanga the most important. Like the point you made, is there a heart connection? Mm-hmm. So on that level is where real sadhusanga begins. So based on that, if I'm connected with the previous acharyas of literature, for instance, their writings and their instructions through their books, am I having sadhusanga? What is the potency of that sadhusanga? Does it make up for the physical lack of sadhusanga?
It's all of these things are sadhusanga. When we read and chant, be with the Vaishnava, this is all part of association. Why we come and meet our teachers and our gurus and our guides is because that relationship, when I develop that relationship, there is something that I can give my heart very fully to. He can respond to me and guide me. So I might be reading the Shastra. You know, there's a famous saying, isn't it? I read the Bible.
Day and night.
Day and night, you read black and I read white. So the thing is that we're reading these teachings, but we may not either understand or fully get the full understanding of these teachings. So therefore, associating with these Vaishnavas, they give us deeper access into understanding them, but more importantly is that by pleasing them, we feel that our heart is connected in that way. So in reading, it is sadhusanga.
It's better than nothing.
It's
the point I'm trying to make.
Very good.
Yeah.
It's very wonderful by reading and chanting and all these things. And at the same time, you're saying that by hearing from Maharaj, then you're feeling the need for that as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
Following instruction of your guru, that's the main way to associate with your guru.
I would love to swan off with all the sannyasins and go to India 4 or 5 times a year.
But
I don't know. That's what happens to me. Sit there and rot.
No, so this is what the chance is to hear from the Vaishnavas. And when we get the chance, to serve them.
Then it's like a spiritual injection.
Yes.
And you get that direct
That's right.
association.
When you get that
it's
direct
like,
association.
It's like a boost.
Exactly. And that's like why we've all come here today,
mm-hmm.
is to associate. It's not that you are not associating,
mm-hmm.
you've come here today. And what we're doing is we got to see Maharaj, we discuss his teachings, and all these things.